Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about double circulatory system and heart. Let's look at what is double circulation. Double circulation means that the blood passes through the heart twice in one complete circuit. This can be explained by the two circulatory pathways, which are the pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation.
In the pulmonary circulation, blood flows from the heart to the lungs and back to the heart. Blood enters the lungs at low pressure, allowing for blood to be well oxygenated before it is returned to the heart during pulmonary circulation. In the systemic circulation, blood flows from the heart to the rest of the body and back to the heart.
Blood leaves the heart for the systemic circulation at high pressure, ensuring that oxygenated blood is distributed to the body tissues faster. These are some of the main blood vessels that are important to note.
The pulmonary artery that carries blood from the heart to the lungs.
The pulmonary vein that carries blood from the lungs to the heart.
The hepatic artery that carries blood from the heart to the liver.
The hepatic vein that carries blood from the liver to the heart.
The renal artery that carries blood from the heart to the kidney.
The renal vein that carries blood from the kidney to the heart. Now let's look at the anatomy of the heart.
This diagram here shows the arteries, veins, atrium and valves that can be found in the heart.
Do note that the arteries carry blood away from the heart,
and the veins carry blood to the heart.
The main arteries of the heart are the pulmonary artery and the aorta. The main veins of the heart are the pulmonary vein, the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava.
The valves that can be found in the heart are the bicuspid or mitral valve, the tricuspid valve and the semilunar valves.
We will now look at the cardiac cycle in greater detail.
In this cardiac cycle graph pressure, the purple line represents the aortic pressure, the pink line represents the ventricular pressure and the red line represents the atrial pressure.
We will use this diagram of the heart to explain what happens at each stage of the cardiac cycle.
Do note the locations of the various valves as labeled.
Additionally, it is important to know what diastole and systole is. They refer to the two phases of the cardiac cycle.
They occur as the heart beats, pumping blood through a system of blood vessels that carry blood to every part of the body.
Systole occurs when the heart contracts to pump blood out, and diastole occurs when the heart relaxes after contraction. In the first stage of the cardiac cycle, it is the atrial systole.
The atria contacts while the ventricles are relaxed. This causes the blood pressure in the atria to be higher than in the ventricles.
If we look at the cardiac cycle graph, you can see in the blue box, the red line is above the pink line, showing that indeed the pressure in the atria is higher than in the ventricles.
Blood flows from the atria into the ventricles through the tricuspid and bicuspid valves.
In the second stage of the cardiac cycle, it is the ventricular systole and atrial diastole. The ventricles now contract while the atria relax,
causing ventricular pressure to increase and exceed the atrial pressure, as can be seen in the blue box, whereby the pink line is way higher than the red line now.
This difference in pressure causes the tricuspid and bicuspid valve, collectively known as the AV valves, to close. This is to prevent blood in the ventricles from flowing back into the atria.
The closing of the AV valves makes the first heart sound loop.
In the third stage, the ventricular pressure exceeds the aortic pressure, as seen in the graph, whereby the pink line is above the purple line. This causes the semilunar valves to open and blood flows into the aorta or pulmonary artery.
In the fourth stage, ventricular diastole occurs, whereby the ventricular pressure decreases as the ventricles start to relax.
As seen in the blue box, the ventricular pressure falls below the aortic pressure. This causes the semilunar valves to close to prevent backflow of blood, and the second heart sound dub is created.
In the fifth stage, the ventricular pressure continues to fall until it is below the atrial pressure, as pointed out by the blue line.
In the sixth stage, the ventricular pressure falls below the atrial pressure, as seen in the blue box. This causes the AV valves to open and blood flows into the ventricles.
The filling of blood in the ventricles is also known as passive ventricular filling.
In the last stage, the blood pressure in the atria and the ventricles continue to rise as they receive blood, as seen in the blue box.
atrial systole begins again and the cycle repeats. That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.